Welcome to the Billy Shultz Music Podcast.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah. It looks great. It sounds great, my friend. How are you?
Good. How are you? Good to see you.
I'm great, man. It's
good
to see you as
well.
Oh, 100%. 100%. You got the premium setup here, man. It looks great. I like it.
I try.
I usually have everybody, when we start off the podcast, just, you know, introduce yourself, tell anybody who's going to watch who you are, where you come from, what you do, like give us as, you know, full of a backstory as you'd like to kick it off.
Okay, sounds great. So my name is Davide Pannozzo. I was born in Italy and I moved to New York 6 years ago, pretty much. So I am a guitar player and singer. I have 6 albums on my name, hundreds of shows worldwide, and my last album, Unconditional Love, was produced by Steve Jordan and Will Lee, as well as the last single, Be Blessed, that we released actually on July the 8th. And I'm also the creator of the GuitarLab, an academy, online academy dedicated to the modern blues guitar, which is my main thing. So that's it.
Beautiful, beautiful. Have you always been blues influenced, or because I know you've been playing, from what I can see, pretty much your entire life? Was it always blues influenced, or did you kind of like jump in between genres?
Well, actually, I started. Pretty early, around I was 6 years old. So my teacher at the time introduced me to classical guitar and also electric guitar. So I kind of have both a side on my musical influence. So classical guitar, but also blues, jazz. I always very interested in the modern stuff. So yeah, classical and blues, jazz, rock. My father is a huge music fan. I grew up on records like Electric Ladyland or Miles Davis kind of blues. So I was very lucky for that.
Absolutely. And you went to school at the Conservatory of Santa Cecilia, is that correct?
That's right. That was my classical side. Yeah, I was graduated in a conservatory in Rome. Yeah.
Can you describe just your time there and how, you know, what that was like and how that kind of changed your, you know, your skill level?
Right. Well, it was, you know, I hated it when I was doing it because, you know, it's completely different, you know, because the classical guitar and all those rules. And actually, at some point I was, like around 14 years old, 15 years old, I was like in the morning studying classical guitar and in the afternoon teaching modern stuff on another school. So I was like living two lives, I guess. But it was so interesting because now I really appreciate that, because I think the classical guitar gave me, you know, that kind of attention for the melody, you know? So it was pretty interesting, and we used to do a lot of laboratory with other instruments. You know, the classical guitar is not an orchestral instrument, so you have to try to fit yourself in different situations to have the same kind of experience that a violin can have in a conservatory. So it was pretty interesting. It was pretty interesting. But again, I hated it, but now I really appreciate that.
Absolutely. And do you think it kind of sounds like blues was kind of like a little bit of your like rebellious, like your rebellion away from the classical side of it?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, actually, I was lucky with that because one of my teachers in the conservatory was actually, you guys should check it out because it's great. His name is Arturo Tallini, which is contemporary classical guitar. So he used to improvise, he used to hit the guitar, and you know, beautiful, beautiful musician. So we used to hang out and talk about jazz, but also obviously the classical repertoire. So it was a kind of interesting mix at the very end of my path in the conservatory. But at the very beginning, absolutely, I was the bad guy in the conservatory, you know, playing the electrical guitar.
Right, how dare you?
Yeah, exactly. I had to hit my electric guitar in the bathroom because of my two lives, you know, in the morning, classical, and in the afternoon, electric guitars.
Oh, wow, that's so funny.
To hide my guitar.
Oh, wow. Yeah. So from there, I know that you're, you know, that was a while ago, but I know that you're living in New York now. Are you, can you describe the journey between mm-hmm. the two? You know, what brought you out on this side?
Yeah. So I love New York. It's a very tough city, but, you know, it's beautiful if you want to do this for a living, because, you know, lots of opportunities to get in touch with the biggest name in the music business. And I moved here, again, thanks to my previous record, because I, like, it was 2016, I guess, and I was living in London. So I moved from Rome to London, and I just released an album with Universal Music, which is Born Electric, with, you know, pretty decent guest stills with Robin Ford, Carver Ryan, David Garfield, a very nice album. And I was writing new stuff at that time. So my brother, Simone, which is an incredible drummer and teacher too, it's a really unbelievable musician. You can check it out on Instagram. He told me, why don't you send your stuff to somebody in the US? So I decided to try. And, you know, I didn't have any contact at the time, but I knew that I loved Steve Jordan because, you know, he produced the best records out there, like Robert Cray, Keith Richards, obviously John Mayer. But I loved the way he produced new stuff, new material, and also as a drummer. So I sent some music to his management, and after a week or so, I got a call from him. And I was interested to do something together. So with my wife, we decided to, you know, to do this big leap, and we decided to invest 6 months of our life in New York. So that's how it went.
And now you're stuck, right? You fell
yeah,
in love
I'm
with
stuck.
The city.
Exactly. Exactly. I fell in love with the city. I have a kid here. He was born in New York. So, you know, I feel like I have to stay here.
100%. Yeah, congratulations.
I love it. Yeah.
Congratulations, my friend. Is that why you chose New York over somewhere, say, like Chicago or Los Angeles or like another major city?
Well, that's primarily the thing, but I also have to say that I always thought about New York as one of my dream, you know, because it's such a great melting pot with blues, funk, jazz, and again, it's a great opportunity to you know, to grow musically speaking. You can go out and see beautiful gigs, shows, theater, everything. So it's really, really interesting, and also beautiful studio, great productions, very easy. If you have to say something, you know, musically speaking, it's very easy to, you know, to get in touch with this beautiful musicians and have a collaboration with them. So,
absolutely. Yeah. Yeah, it's an incredible city. It is an incredible city. I listened to the most recent single, Be Blessed, that you had just released back in July. It's awesome. Anybody who's watching, go check it out. Are you gigging that right now with like your last album, or what are you doing for your day to day right now?
Yeah, so we're going to have some shows coming up on September. We have with my trio, we have a gig at the Bitter End, September the 22nd. And also on November we're gonna have a show with Willie, Sean Pelton, and Osnoy as a special guest, always at the Bitter End. And then we're going to start going back to the studio and, finish a couple of new numbers that we're going to release by the end of the year, I guess. So, yeah.
Are you working on the new music with the same guys that did Be Blessed and your last album?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Aside from playing shows, are you you're teaching out there as well, or what else do you have going on aside from the gigging?
Yeah, so I have, as I mentioned before, this online academy, the Guitar Lab, which is based on the stuff that I play, basically. So all the modern blues kind of stuff. And that's a very interesting project to me. I started a few years ago when I moved to New York. And we have hundreds of students around the world. So it's a really an interesting project. I create all the time new contents for them. So basically you can sign up and access my program, and I have feedback with my students. So I create a live masterclass a couple of times a month. So yeah, it's pretty intense, and I love it because I love to teach and help people to get their own sound on the guitar. So it's really interesting to me.
Absolutely. And yeah, describe Guitar Lab a little bit more for me. So is it like a monthly payment and you're constantly releasing new things? Is there an entire course that, you know, students go through? What's the like the full breakdown of that course?
Yeah, so basically it's like an academy. So you sign up and you get access to the full program, and we can I prepare a tailored program for each student. So they basically receive an email once they sign up, and based on their experience, their level, I'm gonna say them what to study. And after that, they're gonna send me videos, and I'm gonna send them a feedback on that. So I will say, yeah, okay, that's fine. You can work on this. Check the lesson. Go and check that masterclass, or we can move on the comping stuff, or we can deepen the soloing, or we can study the harmony. So it's really a personalized program that I build on every student. So you get an access to everything with a really small a monthly fee, and you can get a lot of material that you can work on. So it's really interesting. And also the live masterclass. So every couple of weeks I do this live masterclass for everyone. So I bring new stuff constantly, and also the student can ask me to do something on a specific topic. So it's really fun.
It sounds awesome. The masterclass is only available to the students, right? Because I was looking at your YouTube page. I don't know if I saw like a live stream that you did. I don't know, it was a couple months ago. I didn't know if that was like part of the live masterclass as well, or if the masterclass only happens within the academy.
Yeah, that happens only in the academy. I think the live stream that you watched, it was a thing that I do every couple of weeks on my YouTube channel. But it's just me playing and chatting with people. So it's not the teaching stuff. It's more like a webcast that I do where I, when I play my music, if people have some questions, I can answer to that. But the master classes are more classes that are dedicated to the students, and that they are just available for the subscribers. Yeah.
Gotcha. Your Instagram account seems like it's kind of blowing up. Is that a new thing that just kind of started happening recently, or have you always been as active as you are on Instagram?
Well, actually, yeah, it's been blowing up in the last few months. I just started to posting more frequently during the pandemic, and all of a sudden it was like this. I got tons of new subscribers. So I guess it depends on the algorithm. So I don't know what happens actually, but I just, I decided to post something that I really like. I just post very short reels where I play riffs or short solo, or I'm doing something that I really think is fun. Just I pick some songs and that are not blues related, and I improvise on that. So I did some soloing on Eminem stuff, or I don't know, Harry Styles, something like that, just for fun, you know? And I think people appreciate that. So Instagram said, okay, let's give some visibility to this guy. So that's what happened.
Are you seeing the same kind of success on other platforms like YouTube and TikTok that as you are on Instagram, or is it mainly Instagram is seeing the most success right now?
Well, I focused on Instagram mainly. Basically those are the same contents that I post primarily on Instagram. So on Instagram works. We'll see if that works on the other socials too. But I think, you know, it's you have to invest a lot of time, as you know better than me. So it's better to, when you find something, to follow the river, you know, and I guess it's the best strategy to not be too overwhelmed, also because I need to create more contents and more music, you know. I don't want to be, you know, a slave of social media. So that's what I try to do. So I decided to focus on Instagram for now, and I do webcasts, as I told you before, every couple of weeks. I'll be starting on September again. I was in Europe for about 2 months, so I stopped the webcast on YouTube. So I'll be live again soon on September. And and we'll see what will be the next step, basically. Yeah.
Does it seem like the amount of traffic that you've gotten to your Instagram has converted into a lot more new students for the Guitar Lab course?
Yeah, that's for sure. And also, I got a pretty nice attention for my music, which was my main goal when I started social media. That is basically something to to look at it if you really want to to have a better a larger audience for whatever your business is. So if you want to get more attention for your music, absolutely you have to invest, if not money, some time on a social media to have a bigger audience. And that happens to me. Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah, I do the same thing. I have my own music as well. So in all social media posts, YouTube, Instagram, I do the same thing. I try and drive the traffic to the music. And it looks like it's working for you, man. So congratulations on that for sure. I like
thank
to
you,
ask,
you.
With somebody who's an accomplished guitarist like yourself, you've been playing for years. Do you still set aside like personal practice time where, you know, it's just you and the guitar and you brush up on different skills, or are you just playing so much already that it just kind of encapsulates anything that you would sit down and work on privately?
Mm-hmm. I constantly practice, constantly. So I guess that is a secret to have more ideas for your music as well. It happens to me actually that I was studying something and a new idea coming up, and then I will write a new song on that. So it's one of the most important things if you want to keep a connection to new music and new stuff, especially if you are in a city like this where everything happens, and you know, you always have to study and to be open to learn from anybody and from everything. So I listen to lots of music and I try to practice as much as I can. And also because I have, a great responsibility with my students, you know? So if you have a large number of students, you have to be aware that you are a guide for them. So, and I have a pretty different level from beginner to advanced to professionals in my academy. So, you know, it's fun. It's, gives me the opportunity to, you know, to level up my playing little by little. It's always a matter of that. So
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. Looking forward, is your main focus more so getting out and gigging and writing this new album you got coming up? Are you trying to get more students for the Guitar Lab? Are you going to be focused more on social media? Like, moving forward in the future, what's your main focus that you're going to be trying to put more of your time towards?
Since we are most likely in a post-pandemic, I would like to, to tour more in Europe, in the U.S., so I'm working in that direction, and also writing new music, getting back in the studio. That is something that I really love. So I would say, more touring, more music. That's my priorities, and also obviously more students. But it's a combination of things, you know. Once you do something that you really love, you know, everything is affected by that. So, yeah.
Yeah, most, you know, I know exactly the struggle, because, you know, when it comes to being a musician, you kind of got to be a jack of all trades and keep your hand in a little bit of everything, you know, the music, teaching, social media, yeah. you kind of got to do a little bit of it all. So it's hard to balance it sometimes, but it seems like you've got a pretty good idea, especially now with, you know, I'm sure New York is wide open. So I'm sure you've been pretty happy to get back out and try and gig more. When are you going into the studio? You said it's towards the end of this year to try and work on your next album.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, we started to work on a couple of new numbers, and we have to finish the production. So yeah, I am hoping to release a couple of new songs by the end of this year. Yeah.
And what kind of music? Still mainly blues focused? Are you going to be throwing any other genres in there? Or
yeah, pretty much the same thing. I released an instrumental, as you mentioned before. So the next two are going to be actual song where I sing too. And it's going to be fun.
And is there a concept behind the album, or is it just kind of you're just jamming with the guys and it's just whatever you're coming up with? Or do you have like a concept that's going to be behind it?
Well, the concept, the idea more than a concept is to, keep the momentum going and release as much single that I can. So, it's not a matter, because I think it's not a good strategy to just release a full album and that it will just die in 3 months, 6 months, you know. It's better to me to, you know, keep the momentum going and release a new single, you know, maybe in 2-3 months, and then another one, and maybe at the end of the next year I'm going to release an album with a whole concept. So that is the idea, just focusing on new stuff that I love, and I'm very lucky to have the opportunity to work with these guys. So it's a bless.
Yeah, in this day and age, your strategy is probably the smartest one, because everyone's so focused on, you know, the immediate gratification. I don't really know very many people, at least in the newer generations, who are sitting down and listening to whole albums front to back. They do want the immediate, here's a song, you know, and hopefully they listen to the whole thing and not just the first 30 to 60 seconds. But that's kind of like the mindset that we're in. So I think the strategy you have is probably the smartest one for sure.
Yeah, thank you. We'll see.
Yeah, no worries. I like to ask everybody, you know, towards the end of these podcasts, because I got a lot of beginners that watch the channel. Is there, what would be like one of your biggest pieces of advice to somebody who's just starting out playing guitar? Because, it can be extremely frustrating. I like to ask, what's like just the biggest piece of advice that you could give somebody who's just starting out?
I would say just play stuff that you love without thinking about results. I mean, you really need to love what you're doing. That is my secret. You know, every time I need to clear my mind and I need to, understand what the next step is, I just pick my guitar and I play just what I love. That is the common thing, no matter the level. So if you just started, just pick the guitar and try to play something that you really love. You know, that's the secret of it all. And just don't be stressed about the results. As you told you before, you don't have to focus on that, because when you do something that you love, results will come. I'm pretty sure about that.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Well, look, my brother, is there anything else you want to like plug or promote? Do you want to drop like your social media link so anybody who's watching could go find you, or anything else that you want to like promote? I'll give you a couple minutes to kind of, you know, shout out social media, website, whatever it may be.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, if you just want to take a look at my music, just go on davidepannozzo.com. Or if you want to follow me on Instagram, my ID is davide.pannozzo. Or if you want to check my YouTube as well, youtube.com, just Davide Pannozzo. Okay?
Sounds good, brother. Hey, I appreciate you taking the time, and good luck with everything moving forward, my man.
Thank you,
I'm going to be looking out, and whenever you drop the new music, I'll be listening to it for sure.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Thank you for
having me. Absolutely. I'll talk to you soon, brother. Okay.